Samurai Champloo has been widely known as one of the best anime. From music to artwork to fights, this anime has everything. Although the anime warns in the beginning that it is not historically accurate, there are some characters in the show that directly relate to real-life historical figures. In this video, I'll be looking at the character Joy Cartwright from episode 23 titled Baseball Blues. We get our first glimpse of Joy Cartwright as he arrives in Japan with his fleet. His interpreter introduces him as Commodore Joy Cartwright, but interestingly enough, the subbed on Crunchyroll also adds Alexander before Joy, which makes it quite obvious that this character is based on the father of baseball, Alexander Joy Cartwright Jr. He was one of the founders of the Knickerbocker Club, the first organized baseball league. However, Cartwright never traveled to Japan. Later, his interpreter states that they are here to open trade in Japan, which is not exactly taken well by the man in charge. Joy is angered and fires cannons as a way to intimidate the Japanese. The Americans are aggressive and say that they are not here to request trade, but to order it. With a little research, it's easy to determine that the character Joy Cartwright is also modeled after Matthew Perry. No, not that one. Matthew Calbraith Perry, the man who played a leading role in the opening of Japan to the West. Perry first visited Japan in 1853 when he reached Uraga at the entrance to Edo Bay. In an aggressive act, he ordered his ships to move past Japanese lines towards the capital of Edo, and also turned their guns towards Uraga. He then attempted to intimidate the Japanese by sending them a white flag and a letter that said America would destroy them if they decided to fight. This was followed with blank shots being fired from his cannons, which he said were done to celebrate American Independence Day, but it was obviously an intimidation tactic as well. This is similar to what we see in the anime, with the American fleet barging onto shore and firing cannons as a means to intimidate the Japanese people. The shogunate, having seen the power of America, agreed to open Japan to the Americans. Obviously, this is not what happened in this episode. The link to Cartwright Jr. is more evident when we see how excited and surprised Cartwright is when he sees a baseball in Japan. They get challenged to a baseball game and are defeated in a comedic fashion. The narrator notes how the Americans went back home with a profound fear of Japanese people. But in order to keep the story somewhat historically accurate, the narrator states how the next time Americans returned was in 1853 with Commodore Perry as the leader. Thanks for watching this quick little video. I'm going to try and make a few more videos regarding the historical aspects of Samurai Champloo before I attempt to move on to other things. Please let me know what you thought of the video. Thanks again.